Hello and welcome to 3D Nat. My name's Anat, and in today's video we're going to create this Rubik's Cube in Blender. For the Rubik's Cube, we're going to need 26 base cubes. And from these 26, there are 6 with one colored face, 12 with 2, and 8 with 3. So we only need to model 3 base cubes. Let's create the first base cube. Press A to select all objects in the scene, and X to delete. On scene, go to Units, and set length to millimeters. Press Shift plus A to add, go to Mesh, and select Cube. Expand the Add Cube menu, and set the size to 90 millimeters. To zoom on a cube, press Numpad dot. Now let's make sure we can see the front, left, and top views. Press Numpad 1 to go to the front view, and rotate it until we can see all three. To edit the mesh, press Tab to go to Edit Mode. To create round corners, let's bevel these edges. Press Ctrl plus B to bevel, and Enter to confirm. Set Width to 1 mm, and Segments to 4. Now let's subdivide this base cube. Press Ctrl plus R to create a loop cut, type 5, and Enter 2 times to confirm. Press Ctrl plus R to create a loop cut, type 5, and Enter 2 times to confirm. Press Ctrl plus R to create a loop cut, type 5, and Enter 2 times to confirm. As I want the colored faces to have round corners, let's separate these faces. Select these 3 middle vertices and press Ctrl plus plus sign 3 times to select more. To separate, press B and choose selection. Now we need to edit this new mesh. Press Tab to exit edit mode, select this new mesh, and press Tab to go back to edit mode. As I'm going to bevel these 4 corners, let's remove these loop cuts. A fast way to do this is to select any corner vertex and press Shift plus G to select similar. Select the amount of connecting edges and press Ctrl plus I to invert selection. Now press X to delete and select Dissolve Edges. Let's do an inset to create the colored faces. Press A to select all, I to inset, type 1, and Enter to confirm. Now press Ctrl plus I to invert selection, X to delete, and select Vertices. Before we bevel these corners, let's subdivide these faces once. This way, after the bevel, we'll have the right amount of vertices to connect these two meshes together. Press A to select all, right mouse, and select Subdivide. Select any corner vertex, and press Shift plus G to select similar. Select amount of connecting edges, press Shift plus Ctrl plus B to vertex bevel, and Enter to confirm. Set width to 2 mm, and segments to 4. To make the editing a bit easier, let's remove these middle vertices. Select these 3 vertices, press X to delete, and select Dissolve Vertices. Now let's join these meshes together. Press Tab to exit edit mode, Shift select the first mesh, press Ctrl plus J to join, and Tab to go back to edit mode. To create the faces, let's use Bridge. Select these 2 edge loops, press Ctrl plus E, and select Bridge Edge Loops. Select these 2 edge loops, press Ctrl plus E, and select Bridge Edge Loops. Select these 2 edge loops, press Ctrl plus E, and select Bridge Edge Loops. Now I'm going to use Extrude and Bevel to create the colored faces. But before that, let's create some edge loops and create seams for the UV map. The crease will make sure these corners remain sharp after the subdivision modifier. And the seams are used to flat this 3D shape onto a 2D plane to apply the textures. To create the seams, press 2 to enable edge selection. Select this edge loop, press Shift plus G to select similar, and select Face Angles. Set Threshold to 0, press U for UV mapping, and select Mock Scene. To create the edge crease, press 1 to enable Vertex Selection. Select these 3 edge loops, press Shift plus Z to crease, type 1, and Enter to confirm. Now press Alt plus Z to extrude, and select Extrude Faces along Normals. This way, we are able to extrude all 3 faces at once. Now type -1, and Enter to confirm. This will create an extrusion of -1 mm along each face normal. Press Alt plus E to extrude, and select Extrude Faces along Normals. Now type 1, and Enter to confirm. Press Ctrl plus B to bevel, and Enter to confirm. Set Width to 1 mm, and Segments to 4. Now to remove all duplicate vertices, press A to select all, M to merge, and select by distance. One last thing we need to do here is to connect these vertices to create quads. And for that, let's use Grid Fill. Select this edge loop, Press Shift plus G to select similar and select amount of connecting edges. Now press X to delete and select faces. Select this edge loop, press F3 and select grid fill. Set span to 4 and change offset until the edges are straight. Now repeat the same steps on the other two faces. After that, we just need to duplicate it to create the other two. The base cube with three colors is complete. Press Tab to exit edit mode so we can create the other two base cubes. Press Shift plus D to duplicate and enter to confirm. Press Shift plus D to duplicate and enter to confirm. Now let's rename these meshes. Go to Layers and rename them. C1.001, C2.001, and C3.001. Let's edit the C1 base cube. Select the C1.001 and press numpad slash to isolate selection. On this one, we'll leave only the top color. Press Tab to go to edit mode, select these two middle vertices, and press Ctrl plus plus sign 8 times to select more. Now press X to delete and select faces. And to fill these faces, let's use grid fill. Select an edge loop, press F3, grid fill, set span to 6, and change offset if needed. Select an edge loop, press F3, grid fill, set span to 6, and change offset if needed. Now press Tab and numpad slash to exit edit and isolate modes. Let's edit the C2 base cube. Select the C2.001 and press numpad slash to isolate selection. On this one, we'll leave the top and front colors. Press Tab to go to edit mode, select this middle vertex, and press Ctrl plus plus sign 8 times to select more. Now press X to delete and select faces. Select this edge loop, press F3, grid fill, set span to 6, and change offset if needed. Press Tab and numpad slash to exit edit and isolate modes. Now we have our three base cubes. We just need to create copies and move them into place. I'll start with the top four C3 cubes. Press N to show the sidebar and select the C3.001. Set the X location to -19 mm, the Y location to -19 mm, and the Z location to 19 mm. Now I'm going to reset the origin point of this cube. This will help us create the other copies. Press Ctrl plus A to apply and select location. Now we just need to duplicate and rotate it to create the other top C3 cubes. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, Z to lock axis, type 90, and enter to confirm. To create the other two, press Shift plus R 2 times to repeat last. Now I'll create the top four C2 cubes. Select the C2.001, set the Y location to -19 mm, and the Z location to 19 mm. Press Ctrl plus A to apply, and select location. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, Z to lock axis, type 90, and enter to confirm. To create the other two, press Shift plus R 2 times to repeat last. Now the top C1 cube. Select the C1.001 and set the Z location to 19 mm. Press Ctrl plus A to apply and select location. Now create the center four C1 cubes. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, X to lock axis, type 90, and enter to confirm. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, Z to lock axis, type 90, and enter to confirm. To create the other two, press Shift plus R 2 times to repeat last. Now create the center four C2 cubes. Select the C2.001, press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, Y to lock axis, type -90, and enter to confirm. Press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, Z to lock axis, type 90, and enter to confirm. To create the other two, press Shift plus R 2 times to repeat last. Now create the bottom cubes. Select all top cubes, press Shift plus D to duplicate, R to rotate, X to lock axis, type 180, and enter to confirm. To make it easier to create the materials later on, let's join our 26 cubes. Press A to select all cubes, Ctrl plus J to join, F2, and rename it RC.001. The cube is complete. We just need to add a subdivision modifier. Press Ctrl plus 2 to add a level to a subdivision surface modifier, right mouse, and select Shade Auto Smooth. Now let's unwrap and create the materials. To unwrap, go to the UV editing workspace. The idea here is to add surface imperfections like scratches and fingerprints. So as the Rubik's Cube has moving parts, I'll create a random unwrap. And as we already created the seams, this will be very fast. On the 3D viewport, press A to select all, and numpad dot to zoom on selection. Now press U to unwrap, and select conformal. Now the mesh is ready for shading. So let's go to the shading workspace. I'm going to make some changes here to leave only the shader editor and the 3D viewport. This way it will be easier for you to see the full node tree. And make sure to enable the node wrangler add-on. You can find it on Edit, Preferences, Add-ons. For this mesh, I'll use two PBR textures from AmbientCG.com, Fingerprint 002 and Scratches 003. I'll leave a link in the video description if you want to download. I'm using the 1K JPEG version. On the shader editor, click here to add new material and rename it black. Now we need to add some nodes. Press Shift plus A, go to Texture, and add an Image Texture node. Press Shift plus D and duplicate the Image Texture node. Now press Shift plus R to create another two copies. On the first one, load the Fingerprint 002 Roughness Map and set it to non-color. On the second one, load the Scratches 003 Color Map and set it to non-color. On the third one, load the Fingerprint 002 Normal GL Map and set it to non-color. And on the fourth one, load the Scratches 003 Normal GL Map and set it to non-color. Let's use a Node Wrangler feature. Hold Shift plus Control, right mouse, drag and release to create a mix between these two roughness maps. Set Blending Mode to Add and Factor to 0.5. Connect the result to the principal shader's roughness socket. Repeat the mix between the two normal maps, set Blending Mode to Mix and Factor to 0.1. Click and drag the result, release, type normal map, and select color. Connect the normal map to the principal shader's normal socket. On base color, set color to black. As I want these scratches to be smaller, let's use another node wrangler feature. Select one of them and press Ctrl plus T to add texture coordinate and mapping nodes. Set scale to 3 and connect to the other. And as I'm not going to scale the fingerprint maps, we can leave them without these. By default, Blender already set image textures to UV coordinate. The base material is complete, and from it, we can create the other six. To create them, let's go to Materials. Click here to add a new material slot, and select the black material from this list. Click here to make it a single user, rename it white, and set base color to white. Click here to add a new material slot, and select the white material from this list. Click here to make it a single user, rename it yellow, and set base color to yellow. Click here to add a new material slot, and select the white material from this list. Click here to make it a single user, rename it green, and set base color to green. Click here to add a new material slot, and select the white material from this list. Click here to make it a single user, rename it blue, and set base color to blue. Click here to add a new material slot, and select the white material from this list. Click here to make it a single user, rename it orange, and set base color to orange. Click here to add a new material slot, and select the white material from this list. Click here to make it a single user, rename it red, and set base color to red. Now we only need to assign them to parts of the mesh. On the 3D viewport, press numpad 7 to go to top view, and tap to go to edit mode. Select these 9 vertices, and press Ctrl plus plus sign 6 times to select more. Select the white material, and click assign. Press numpad 9 to flip to bottom view, select these 9 vertices, and press Ctrl plus plus sign 6 times to select more. Select the yellow material, and click assign. Press numpad 1 to go to front view, select these 9 vertices, and press Ctrl plus plus sign 6 times to select more. Select the green material, and click assign. Press numpad 9 to flip to back view, select these 9 vertices, and press Ctrl plus plus sign 6 times to select more. Select the blue material, and click assign. Press numpad 3 to go to the left view. Select these 9 vertices and press Ctrl++ sign 6 times to select more. Select the orange material and click Assign. Press Numpad 9 to flip to the right view. Select these 9 vertices and press Ctrl++ sign 6 times to select more. Select the red material and click Assign. The materials are complete. Let's go back to the layout workspace. One last thing I'd like to show is how to separate these 26 cubes. To separate them, press A to select all, B to separate, select by loose parts, and exit edit mode. And as you can see here on layers, we now have 26 separate meshes. And there you have it, a realistic 3D model of a Rubik's Cube. If you're still here, it means you are liking the content of this channel. I really want to thank you for spending your time with me learning some basic Blender. I hope you have enjoyed as much as I have making it. So please, consider subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it, and leave a comment. Thanks a lot for watching, and see you on the next one. Bye bye.